So, today's topic is normal, opportunistic and saprophytic bacterial flora. So, first of all, we'll know about the normal bacterial flora. What is the normal bacteria flora? Actually, bacteria is present in all the natural environment. And the animal of any kind are in contact with the microorganism, means the bacteria. And these bacteria are present abundantly in the habitat where they find food, moisture and temperature appropriate for their growth and their multiplication. And the mammalian bodies acts as a favorable environment for the growth and of the microorganism, and bacteria are present in the mammalian host or on their body. And the microflora which is present at any site in a healthy animal is called as normal flora. So it may be in normal flora, among normal flora, bacteria is one of the component, and some of these bacteria may be anaerobic, facultative anaerobic, and these can be of three types. And these are symbionts, commensal, and the opportunistic. What is the symbionts? Means the such bacteria which gets benefited themselves and also they benefit the host. And commensal, the bacteria which remain present in the host but they do not have seem to be any benefit to the host. And the opportunistic, actually these are the bacteria which harm host and they can cause disease in the host under certain circumstances, like when the immunity is lowered or host is injured or in a stress condition, then opportunistic bacteria, normally they do not harm and they are having low virulence, but the under certain conditions they harm the host. And the animal body is not a uniform microbial habitat. Some of the organs, they may have a more number of bacteria, some of them have low number of the bacteria, and skin, oral cavity, gastrointestinal tract, respiratory tract, and genitourinary tract are the places or the system where environment is favorable to favor the growth of the certain type of the microorganism. Among all the host organ systems, the skin and the digestive system is the favorable system of the host and which contains the most diverse and the complex bacterial flora. And there seems to be a tissue tropism. Tissue tropism means the some tissue or some organ are favorable for the growth of the bacteria, some are not. And in a specific type of the tissue or system organs, specific type of the bacteria will grow. Like in the skin, gram-positive bacteria like Staphylococcus cyanobacterium are more present. These are the gram-positive bacteria are more present rather than in the intestine. Whereas in the intestine, enteric bacteria are present and mostly they are gram-negative, like E. coli, and some gram-negative anaerobics are also present in the intestine. And the composition of the normal microflora vary with the animal species, feed, they what they eat, and the housing condition, including the population of the animals. In one report, it is found that the addition of the organic acid to the feed of the fattening pigs causes the alteration or reduction in the total number of the bacteria because of the change of the composition of the gut flora. Coming to the different organ systems where the normal flora are present, one of them is the digestive tract, which is densely populated, and in the digestive tract, oral cavity, stomach, intestine, these are the parts where bacteria are, normal flora are present. Oral cavity, it contains the strict anaerobic and facultative anaerobic bacteria, and in oral cavity, most complex and heterogeneous microbiological habitat is present, and many type of the bacteria are present in oral cavity. In oral cavity, saliva is secreted, which contains enzymes like lysozyme or lactoperoxidase. Then two, the presence of the food particles and epithelial debris makes the oral cavity a favorable habitat for the growth of the microbial growth. And the bacteria present in the oral cavity are anaerobic bacteria like Bacteroides, Fusobacterium, some of the gram-positive bacteria like Actinomyces, and other bacteria, Actinobacillus, Haemophilus, Moraxella, Micrococcus, these are the bacteria present in the oral cavity. Stomach, relatively few number of the microorganisms are present in the stomach. Why? Because it is having acidic environment. And acidic environment is due to the production of hydrochloric acid in the stomach, which reduces the pH value nearly at the level of 2. And the acidic environment functions as a microbiological barrier against the entry of the foreign bacteria into the intestinal tract. But the acid tolerant bacteria like lactobacilli and streptobacilli are capable to colonize this organ. Some another gastric pathogens like Helicobacter pylori is also present in the stomach, which is a gastric pathogen, and from humans, pigs, cats, and from several other species, this bacteria has been isolated. Small intestine, it can be divided into anterior part and distal part. In interior part, it is having acidic environment, and the bacterial composition will be of the same nature as the stomach. So the in a interior part, mainly the gram-positive bacteria are present, whereas in the distal section, less acidic pH value is there, and it causes the change in the microflora of the bacterial microflora, and so it will be having a richer and the more complex nature of the bacteria in this part. And some of the bacteria which are present in the distal section are belonging to the family Enterobacteriaceae, like Escherichia coli. Some anaerobic bacteria, gram-negative bacteria like Bacteroides are also present. And some other bacteria are Lactobacilli and the Enterococci. Coming to the large intestine. In large intestine, enormous bacterial population is present, and it contains anaerobic bacteria like Bacteroides, Fusobacterium, Clostridium, as well as the facultative anaerobic bacteria like E. coli, Klebsiella. These are the bacteria present in the large intestine. And skin, it also contains the normal flora, and micrococci, coagulase negative staphylococcus are generally present on the skin. And these are normally non-pathogenic and the commensal. But in certain conditions, they become pathogenic and they cause diseases. Even coagulase negative staphylococcus are reported to cause mastitis in the bovine. Also, they cause diseases in humans also. And coming to the respiratory tract, in respiratory tract, sinuses, which is a part of the upper respiratory tract and the lower respiratory tract, are normally free of the bacterial flora. But the nasopharynx, it is highly populated by a large number of the bacterial species, including the Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, and the bacteria belonging to the Pasteuriaceae family. In erogenital tract, many bacteria are also present, and Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, E. coli, etc. These are the bacteria present in the urogenital tract, and some of the infections are caused by these bacteria present on the urogenital tract. These bacteria, normal flora, they are in many sense beneficial to the host, and one of the benefit is that they assist in the digestion of the food. Intestinal flora of the mammals is responsible for the wide variety of the metabolic reaction, and they cause the enzymatic breakdown of the food. And they also produce many vitamins like niacin, vitamin B1, B2, B6, B12, folic acid, biotin, and vitamin K. And production of these vitamins involves the activities of the microorganism, and these enterobacterial population are also have a role in the defense mechanism, and they protect the animal body against the colonization by the invading pathogens. The commensals and the symbionts prevents the colonization by the invading pathogens. How they prevent? They compete for the nutrients and also for the attachment site to which the invading bacteria may attach. So the site will not be free and they will not attach to the intestine, and thus they prevent the disease occurrence. And these normal flora also have a role in the immunity, defense against the pathogens. They produce cross-reactive antibodies, means the components of the normal flora are important in preparing the immune system in defense against the pathogens. How they prevent? These antibodies cross-react the pathogens which are having related or shared antigens, and thus raise the immune status of the host against the invading pathogens. And these normal bacterial flora also stimulate the development of the certain tissues like the lymphatic tissue and also the microflora of the ruminants. They have a crucial role in the development of the rumen in the young ruminants. These microflora also liberate some of the substances like endotoxin, which have a role in defense of the body, and also they liberate the bacteriocin, which is an antibacterial protein liberated by the intestinal flora, and which is having an inhibitory effect against the bacteria, like gram-negative bacteria as well as in the gram-positive bacteria. But along with the benefits, these normal flora are also having some of the disadvantages, like they may become pathogenic if the immunity of the body is lowered, or sometimes if the host gets injury or get into stress, then some of the bacteria which normally remains as a commensal, they can convert into opportunistic pathogen and they can cause the disease. And some of the bacteria which are non-pathogenic in their natural habitat, they can become pathogenic if they migrate to the another tissue, like E. coli, which is a normal inhabitant of the intestinal tract. And if they goes to the urinary tract, they cause their urinary tract infection. Next one is the opportunistic bacterial flora. What is the opportunistic bacterial flora? These are the normally free living or the part of the host normal flora. Opportunistic, name itself indicates, if they get the opportunity, become pathogenic. And they get become pathogenic role they have a pathogenic role under a certain circumstances, if the immunity of the host is lowered, or the host is suffering with some of the other infections, or there is tissue damage, or host is under stress. Generally, these bacteria, opportunistic bacteria, are having low virulence. But if they get the suitable condition and the host, these harmless organisms, they convert into pathogenic bacteria and causes disease. E. coli, Klebsiella, Pseudomonas, and many more bacteria which are opportunistic bacterial pathogens. Coming to the saprophytic bacteria, that some bacteria live on the dead and the decaying organic matters, and such type of the bacteria are known as saprophytic bacteria. Usually these bacteria are present in the soil and the water, and normally they are unable to invade the living body. But somehow, like through the contamination of the food and water, or through the injury, they get intro into the body, or sometimes they remain present in the host, and they can cause diseases under certain circumstances, like Clostridium, Proteus, Pseudomonas. These may remain in the soil as a saprophytic, but when they get into the body and under suitable conditions, they cause diseases. Coming to the infection and types of the infection, what is infection? It is an entry of the organism or in the body, their multiplication, and the damage they cause to the host. But all the infection do not result in the disease. Means sometimes body may get infection, but without causing any disease, the infectious agent may remain present in the body. And what are the types of the infections? Infections may be of primary infection, means the initial infection with the organism in the host. And what is the reinfection? If the same host get the infection with the same organism subsequently, then the infection is known as reinfection. And secondary infection, if the host which is already suffered from another disease and whose resistant is lower and gets an infection with a new organism, then such type of infection is known as secondary infection. Cross infection means if the infection occurs with a new organism from the another host or from the another external source from the environment or another source in the host which is already suffering with another disease, then the such type of infection is known as cross infection. And the infection acquired through the hospitals is known as the nosocomial infections. And some infection, they are introduced into the host by a physician as a result of therapy or investigation procedure. Such type of infections are known as iatrogenic infections. In some infections, host is having infectious agent, but they will not be symptomatic, means they will not show the symptoms of the disease. And such type of the infections is known as subclinical infections. Latent infection, in some host, infectious agent are present, but in the latent form or in hidden stage. And on certain circumstances, like when the immunity is lowered or they are under the stress, they multiply and produce the disease, and then the symptoms of the disease are visual. And such type of the infection, when the infectious agent is present but the symptoms are not shown, then such infection is known as latent infection. What are the sources of the infection? How a host can get infected? What is the source? A person, animal, object, or the substance from which an infectious agent passes or is disseminated to the host is the source of the infection. And source may be endogenous or exogenous. Endogenous means if the normal bacterial flora is there and they are in certain conditions they get activated and cause diseases, then the source is endogenous, means they are arising within from the body. Like the E. coli, which is a normal flora of the intestine, and if it get migrated to the urinary tract, then causes urinary tract infection. Exogenous source, what is the exogenous source? Means that from the outside of the host body. And from the outside of the host body, animal itself may be the source of infection for the other host or other animals. And animals in different stages can be a source of the infection to the other animals or the host, like incubating a disease. Incubation period means that when the infectious agent enters the body, until the time which it shows the symptoms of the disease is the called the incubation period. And during this time, the animal is not showing any symptom, but then too it can disseminate the infectious agent to the outside or through the secretions or the discharges, and it may act as a source of infection for the other animal. Overt disease means that if the animal is suffering with the disease and showing the symptom, then from its discharges through or its excretions, infectious agent comes out, and if the other host gets contacted with their discharges and or directly they get contact with the diseased animal, then they can get the infection. Convalescent carrier, what is it? Is the host which continues to harbor the microorganism even after the recovery from the clinical disease caused by the same pathogen is the convalescent carrier. And they can be a temporary carrier or a chronic carrier. Temporary carrier means the carrier stage lasts for the few days, whereas the chronic carrier, which harbors the microorganism for the long time even after the recovery from the clinical disease. And another type is the contact or subclinical carrier, means the host gets infected, gets the infectious agent without contracting the disease. They will not show any symptoms, but they are able to discharge the infectious agent, and through them another host gets infected. Another source is inanimate sources, means the non-living things like soil, feces. They are in these microorganism or bacteria may be present, and through the contamination of the food and water or equipments or other sources, or through the wound, these bacteria can get into the body and they cause disease. Vectors like insects, mosquitoes, ticks, mice, flies, lice, these are also act as a source of the infection for the healthy host. What are the method of the transmission of the infection? How these bacteria can get into the body? One of the method is contact, either by the direct contact with the diseased animal or through the indirect contact. They can result in the infection. Another method is inoculation. Inoculation of the organism occurs directly into the tissue of the host, like for the in the infection of the tetanus. In bacteria, Clostridium tetani is present in the soil, and if is there infection, host is having any injury or wound, then bacteria from the soil, they get into the tissue of the host, and by getting anaerobic condition, the bacteria multiply and causes the tetanus. Another method is ingestion. Ingestion of the contaminated food and water through the with the microorganism result in the infection. Another method is inhalation. Inhalation, mainly the bacteria causing respiratory diseases are present in the droplet nuclei or in the environment, and through the inhalation these gets into the body. Another is the vectors like mosquitoes, flies, fleas, ticks. These are the source to transmit the bacteria to the host, and these may be of two types: mechanical vectors or the biological vectors. Mechanical transmission means the in the disease causing agent will not replicate and develop into the vector. Simply, it will be transported from the vector from one animal to the another animal, like the flies. And the biological vector means the vector will take the agent through the blood meal or there it will get replicated, and through the blood it will cause the transmission of the disease to another host. And what will be the routes of the portal of the entry of the infectious agent to the body? It will be of different types, like respiratory tract. Generally, the respiratory diseases causing agents get into through the respiratory tract. Like these microorganisms will be trapped in the moist mucous membrane of the nasopharynx, and they will get into the respiratory tract, like bacteria of the tuberculosis, pasteurilosis. They get into through the respiratory tract. Gastrointestinal tract. During intake of the food and water, some infectious agent like bacteria, they get into the gastrointestinal tract, like E. coli and the Salmonella. Genital tract. During the estrus, time of the estrus or after the pasturation, some of the bacteria get into the body. Sometimes due to the coitus also, some bacteria get into entry. And through skin of the mucous membrane, some bacteria are having capability to invert intact skin or mucous membrane, like the brucellosis. Bacteria of the brucellosis means Brucella abortus, and disease like anthrax can be also occur by the such type of the method. Transplacental infection. Fetus get infected through the placenta, and either they become dead, or so the stillborn will be born, or sometimes they get aborted. Like in Campylobacteriosis, brucellosis, and via umbilicus. If the navel is not properly cared after the birth, infection may occur through the umbilicus. And especially the lambs are susceptible with the infection by the umbilicus. And many bacteria like Erysipelagic, Salmonella, E. coli, they get entry into the body through the umbilicus, and they cause disease in the body by this method. So in brief, this is about today's topic. And if you have any doubt, you may ask.